Hey guys, welcome to another episode of the World of Dragons mod. Just a guy here and trying to fix some of our mistakes that we made last time. Namely, this rather pathetic nether portal. Or the complete lack of a nether portal. Because we needed the quartz. It's kind of funny that I played Minecraft for like 2 or 3 years. And I forgot how to make another portal. I mean, I knew vaguely, but I forgot if it was 2x2 or 3x2 or whatever. I know you can make them as big as you want, but for the most part, but I forgot how small you can make it. I did manage to mess around with the backpack a little bit in another world just to try to get the controls to work. And I figured out how to sort of do some stuff. If you push the edit button, when it's open anyway, you can set certain things to automatically be put in there as you pick them up. I couldn't get the resupply thing to work. It's supposed to, I guess, put stuff in your inventory as something runs out. I don't know, I couldn't get it to work. I thought it'd be nice for food or something, but other than that, I couldn't see much of a use for that aspect. Building, maybe, if you're doing a lot of the same block. But, if I added a couple blocks, it'd be useful for not having to worry about, you know, like cobblestone and stuff. But you can just type what it is, or if you have a copy of it in your inventory, then you hit add. Now anytime I pick up cobblestone, like run into it, it'll automatically go into the backpack. Other than that, it's not super useful. I messed with the autoloader like this, and I pushed the button, but it doesn't take things out of chest or anything that I can tell yet, so whatever. So now if I get some cobblestone, I'll show you. Gravel. Get rid of that junk. Oh, and I was also looking at some of that morph mod. I got one, some cobblestone. And apparently if there's more than one of a monster of the same type, you'll get a certain one by default. And you have to push a button to get variations of that same monster type. So when I picked up that creeper and blew myself up in the last episode, I might have been able to get it to work right. Because I was trying to go for the red one that threw the TNT. And I must have just gotten a regular one or whatever when I push the explode button instead. I'm hoping, because I like the idea of being able to throw endless TNT. Huh. So I guess I only have those couple pieces of cobblestone. But let me make another. I don't know how many sticks on me. Can I get rid of them somewhere? Oh, I hear a zombie. I have no sticks. Oh well, I can make sticks. I just waste the wood if I didn't have to. I don't really have any torches either, and I need to go into the deep, deep. Make a stone pickaxe just to save my iron a little bit. So I get a better supply of it. I'll make two because stone pickaxes suck. Especially with a vein miner available, you kind of destroy your items even faster than normal, it seems. But here, I'll show you with this cobblestone. So, if I drop this cobblestone and I pick it up, it'll be in my little backpack. Sort of like some other items I've heard of in some of the skyblock things I've seen. Can't remember the name exactly, but it was a sort of useless item by the time most of the skyblock people got around to it. But okay, yeah. Mess that up. It sounds like there are some zombies and stuff down here. So I got some bad things in my basement. But again, I gotta try to get out of this place. Probably should just build a ladder, but I haven't done that yet. Just trying to get my little quest done. Oh, well, it's nighttime too. There we go. We're gonna sleep to save us a little bit of hassle. Because even with this free set of diamond armor, it's pretty dangerous. I didn't even realize my life was still low. Oops. Ooh, there's a guy right there. Oh, it's just a husk. Huh. You know, quicksand's pretty awesome at capturing mobs. I don't know why I went out here. Not like a zombie mob skin is gonna help. I don't think it prevents them from attacking you or anything. Come on. Can I get out? No, I got out before. Huh. It's funny. Turn it to mud. Get out. I don't know what you'd do if you didn't have a water bucket. I know I got out that first day I ran into this quicksand, but I don't know how you get out of it normally. That's so much pain. So, here we are going diving. I hear a lot of skeletons. Or rattling of bones, anyway. No. Guess I didn't quite go the same way I went in. Okay. Whoa. Oh yeah, I don't know what mod did that, but they have bows when they're far away and they switch to a sword when they get close. That's pretty fun. Creepy even, but fun. Okay, here's my cake. Finish off my cake. Now I need to get a torch and make some more torches because I can't see. And I'll find it, I hear it, there we go. Picking up bat again, because I wanted to try flying last time before I had a horrible accident. There we go. So let's see. Oh, we got a bat. I hear a skeleton. Well, I do fly. But I only have 3 hearts. That's pretty cool though. No super bad ability, although I probably shouldn't have done that last time I died when I messed around with the special abilities of monsters. But what could a bat do, right? Anyways, back to our exploration for lava. Probably, I usually do this my offhand. And I try, if I remember, to put things on the left wall just so that it's easier to find to get out. I don't always remember. Oh, one whole piece of iron. Weird. I held the vein miner, but I didn't get this one. Anyways, no more. No, it's copper or some weird knife thing. I'm just going for the iron because, one, I need it, but two, there's like, get 64 of it for that one quest. Kind of a pain. That's just 64 iron nuggets, either you gotta get 64 iron ores. Ooh, that's so scary. My heart just went like crazy. I almost wish I had a shield. I never really got into the habit of using them though. Okay, this is gonna fill up my inventory real fast. So we're gonna use the fancy dancy backpack key. We're gonna edit by my inventory, bones, add, and how about limestone, add, marble, add. Just to get all the random junk. I have arrows, actually. Why not add the iron to it too? There we go. That in there. Is that everything? Oh, well, the grapes will stay there. Why be in my inventory too long with all these enemies around me? Get some more coal, because we're gonna need a little. Whoa, that was a lot of coal. Oops. Yeah, it's kind of funny when you right-click and you have something in your hand. But those guys are everywhere. They're pretty scary. Okay, I'm gonna actually. I'm a little curious. I guess that looks like about normal diamond gear. It just seems like these have been lasting forever, even with me dying. I just thought they just seemed like they were lasting longer than they normally do. My game audio seems so loud today. Hope it's not too loud for you guys. I had it turned down to 50% on my OBS recording, but I'm not sure. But in my headphones right now, it seems really loud. Which, I usually wear headphones while recording, otherwise, you know, the microphone picks up the audio. But yeah, I just haven't touched them, and for some reason, like, the audio is just really loud. All those skeletons dropped down behind me scare me half to death. I'm not sure if the vein miter helps you pick up items too, but it seems like nice, because I'm getting a lot of them. A lot of sandstone. I know in vanilla Minecraft, usually that means temple, but I guess just any level under the desert. Oh crap. One of these guys again. I got my friendly creeper, but I don't really know what he does. Well, they killed each other. I guess I don't get credit for a soul if I don't kill it, though. Pretty funny. I mean, I don't think I got anything useful. I got stone. That's pretty cool. Oh, I have it. I guess cobblestone and all that gets filtered out too. Or not. I thought I picked up stone. I was just looking at stone. I thought maybe the explosions gave me stone instead of cobblestone. But this is pretty cool. Pretty extensive cave network underneath my place. I'm gonna stop this water because it's annoying. Uh-oh, I hear a spider. So far, the spiders are probably the least dangerous mob. Even the ones with the little baby spiders. So far, I'm doing pretty good on ore. Iron, I guess. Tell you, if I ever wanted to completely fill in these caves for better spawn rates or something, it's gonna take a while. I might hit my first dead end. Or not. Uh-huh. Looks like I got a, wonder if it's a zombie. Yeah, a lot of spiders. I wonder if it's a spider spawner? pretty big cave, right? By the way, there's one down there. It's not. It's been that same one that I thought was right underneath me. Oh. Eat. Oh man, I hate food. Yeah, I always have trouble letting me put torches or food in my offhand. This one didn't switch the sword. Okay, this looks cool. Archaic edge. Don't know what that is. I'm probably gonna have to take it. Okay, this is just crazy expensive. Miner's Delight. I have no idea what that does. But it gave me an advancement. I don't know what's down there. Okay, pickaxe. Oh, this one can harvest it, whatever it is. Do a golem. Okay. If that golem doesn't give me a cool special ability, I don't know what will. Ancient golem. Oh yeah, I got like super hearts. And let's just try this. Hopefully he doesn't kill me. No, I don't shoot little fireballs. Why does it seem like the only monster that has an ability so far is the creeper that kills yourself? But this looks cool. I can jump too. For some reason I thought I wouldn't be able to jump. Just crazy thought, huh? Cake bricks. Yes, let's put them in our little bag. Those might be useful. Who knows? And we'll open our bag again and edit it. I hear skeletons sneaking up on me. I can't select it. What's in my bag? Cake bricks. I'm at my maximum, I think. That's too bad. You can't have. Well, there's some more iron, but I'm gonna finish it. This is cool. I'm not quite sure what it's for. And this is a scary little room. Okay, I still haven't found any lava though. Okay, that's just cool. Whatever this is, something tells me it's normally really hard to get, and I just got it for free. Although this makes it really dark. Hey, why? Oh wow, he doesn't care about me. Wow, this golem mod does make me. I'm just one of the guys now. I'm just an enemy. At least until I can die, and then I'll have to get more. Oops, I don't want to hit him. Something tells me if I hit him, he'll still be angry at me. But I can fully build whatever this was in my base, for whatever reason I need to build it for. I'm out of torches. Tab? Oh yeah, it works. The quality of life changes. The last recipe you did. Bane Miner. Oops. lose my axe. Copper ore, I don't really need it yet. Okay, this is a crazy long tunnel. I'm just saying. And I still haven't found any lava. I mean, I hate cheating, sort of bespeak by pushing F3. But I am at what level? I can never remember where it's at. 35? Right? Yeah. I mean, 35's not super low, but you would think I'd be seeing lava a little bit. I don't know if it's because I'm under a desert, or what. I've never really gone extensively into what happens where, but I would have thought by 35 I'd be hitting some lava. Now there's my last stone pick. But I have a feeling I've earned more than enough iron. Well, only 38. I think I need a few more to get. Hey, don't mind me, I'm just one of you guys. That's so awesome that this actually works. Where's there? But yeah, okay, I gotta say, being a morphed into golem that they all ignore is almost broken. I mean, it's kind of cheesy. I wanna say don't do it ever, but making this way easier than it has to be. I just thought it'd give me a few extra hit points and maybe let me throw fireballs. Treasure slime, huh? Like apple one. Okay, this is pretty awesome little area here. Let's get some coal. We're gonna need a lot of it. This is, I gotta say, an extensive cave. And it's not even like I hit a ravine or anything. I haven't hit any monster spawners or anything either, though. Ooh. Hi, Mr. Creeper. This creeper central, I mean, three of them and no other enemies in this room. That's pretty crazy. And there's a really scary whooshing sound. You guys can hear it. Not sure what that signifies. We got a friendly creeper. The ghost pickaxe. A spider? Oh, and I've done a circle. I see that waypoint's kind of cheating too, but I mean, I like naming my base. Maybe I'll put it on hide. It sort of makes it a lot easier to tell where you're going, just by being able to see one landmark, no matter where you're at. Not much down here now. Well, depending if I want to get more coal or not. I mean, I always need it. Just hoping for some lava. Well, I hit another dead end. For how extensively huge this place is, I actually managed to hit a dead end or two. And here we go. Let's see if there's anything up here. Aha. Oops. Oh, it's cold. Okay, that's scary. Like, skeleton warrior. Looks like he's got like the strength or the haste effect or something on him. But again, because I'm a iron golem, everybody's ignoring me. Kind of, cheap. I think once I'm done with this little run, I'm probably not going to do it again. Or maybe I'll still just fight everything anyway. I like the morph idea, but it just seems kind of cheap if they ignore you all. I didn't think they would. I thought, because I'd done, I think I turned into a skeleton before and they still tried to kill me. But, and I think that was my first playthrough went before the video and audio and stuff went to crap. Well, looks like I actually hit the end of this little endless ravine. Yeah. I have, well, there's monsters or something over here somewhere. I hear screaming. But I'm not going to dig through walls to try to find stuff right now. Just going to try to find my way out. I tried to put everything on the right wall for the most part. I mean, left wall, right wall now. Oh, here's, I don't know what these miners the light are, but I got a couple of them. Oh, some more iron. I should have enough, because I had almost 30 before. I mean, I won't have enough, as in I won't ever need iron again, so much as enough for that quest. I do keep hearing that zombie. I don't think there's like a zombie spawner around here somewhere. And these I thought were cool. I mentioned it before on my, again, the playthrough that got broken. But they glow. And that's really awesome. I like to see things like light sources when you're underground. Unfortunately, they don't glow very brightly, so they don't stop mob spawns or anything. But they do. They let you add an ambience to a room without, again, stopping the mobs if you want them. Lava, finally. Okay, let me get my buckets. Get rid of the water buckets, I don't actually put it out. Okay, we got one lava bucket. I'm gonna need like 2-4 of them, because 2 to do the extra one side that I needed, and then 2 to replace the messed up bottom. Unless I actually find enough diamonds to make a diamond pick. Okay, I wonder if this will be stupid, but I just really think I should hit them to just see how it works. I probably will do that before I leave. Tab. Not a sticks. Why would I need that many? Torches. I need to put some stuff in my backpack. Bricks can go in the backpack. Lava can go in the backpack. And we'll put some coal in there too. Okay. That is, I gotta say, better inventory with the backpacks is just awesome. I never really played Minecraft with the Shulkers. I think the Shulkers and the Elytra just got added to the game when I stopped being able to play, and I'd never actually earned any at the time. Which, again, if you watch my goodbye to my childhood Minecraft world, you'll see that I built my place in the sky, and I died so many times building it because I didn't have no elytra to save me. And I wasn't very particularly safe with what I was doing either. I mean, some of it's my fault. But yeah, I can only imagine how much easier it would have been with an elytra. I gotta say, for all the problems I'm having right now getting lava, I'm having a pretty good job with ore, iron. Not only is it common, but why is there grass down here? Well, I am back up to level 52. I didn't think I was going up that much. Funny, the first bit of lava I found was this high up. Hey, Mr. Creeper guy. Aha, lava. you guys have noticed already. More iron. There's such a thing as too much. One of those funny things about modern Minecraft 2. They have more blocks, more resources, to the point where you can't carry it all. That's like why the mods that give you better resources are so important. I mean, this one gives you backpacks. I don't know what else there is yet. Some of them have like the ME interfaces, but I mean, it's just like so important because they add so much junk that you can't possibly carry it in a vanilla Minecraft backpack. And just this, with a bunch of stuff that doesn't even stack. That's two. I'm gonna have to, I don't have a crafting table. I'm gonna make one. You should always carry a crafting table, but I always forget. Gonna make a few more buckets. I didn't want to make too many of these before because I didn't know if I'd find someone like the dungeon. My iron was pretty limited at the time. Now I got a lot of buckets. Okay, we got my table, my backpack. There we go. Okay. We only need two more lava, and we can build our little portal to the Nether. Oh, and I just like to say I appreciate the few people who have watched my videos. Nobody's really commented yet, but I'm just glad that somebody's watching these. I mean, I'm just playing this mostly because I like Minecraft. And I kind of liked, always wanted to share it with people, but I didn't have the internet to really do multiplayer. Or any friends that really played Minecraft, to be honest. But a few of my friends play other games, but not this one. Which, one of those things I actually want to talk about, if you've ever paid attention to, when I die and stuff, it says Thrasham May I. That's because, he's a character that I've used for quite a few years, to be honest. It started in, like, high school when I played Dungeons and Dragons, and he was a priest, dwarf priest, to be honest. And it was sort of a pun on words because, he was a dwarf priest and he was a father, so his name was Father May I for a long time until he got to be a better priest and eventually got high priest and all that stuff, but that's a very long fall. Very, very big, very deep fall. Wow. Really almost wish I had a spider. Well, I do have a spider, but I don't want to change and get killed and jump down there just to see what happens. But, yeah, he was a dwarf priest named Father May I, you know, sort of a play on words. And I made this account back then, and I was actually making little dwarf fortresses and stuff. Well, he almost pushed me off. Since then, though, I tried to change my name. I don't know if it's broken or I'm just having trouble, but when I go to the Mojang website to change my name, it says available. And then I click my password and hit OK, and then it just keeps processing. It never, ever stops. I don't know if it's broken or what, but I tried it on a couple different days, different times, and it never worked. So it's stuck on Thrasher May I. I mean, I kind of wanted to put it to be my channel name or something, but, you know, whatever. So if you're ever curious, that's why it says that when I die. Or do anything that requires my player name to be actually visible. I mean, I could, I guess, buy the game again, but, you know, why? I gotta say, for the value for money, Minecraft has definitely given me more than almost anything else. Diamond sand. Shovel. I don't even have a shovel. I almost wish I had a shovel because that's the first time I've seen diamond sand. Ever, period. Like, none of the mods I've ever watched before had diamond sand. I don't don't know what it's used for. Or I don't know if it's actually a bad thing. Speaking of, I guess I haven't found any diamonds yet. I mean, I'm not that deep. 23 now, I guess I am. But still, the only diamond I got was the one from the Dragon Horde. Can I use all my sticks? I am always so bad at resource management. Luckily, I brought a lot of wood. Okay, so let's make ourselves... I think I need an iron to harvest the sand. Can I use all my iron? Oh no, I got one iron. Just enough to make my iron shovel. Let's hope this works and I didn't just waste the iron. Oh yes, we got whatever that is good for. Let's actually look at that. So diamond sand uses. Diamond sandstone. Compressed diamond sand. Diamond sand smelts into diamond glass. Diamond glass. So yeah, it's just an aesthetic thing, I guess. No recipes use it other than those things. Oh well, I guess diamond glass isn't as awesome as I thought it was. Might look cool though. Maybe that's what it's good for. Actually surprised there are actually no recipes for it. I mean, other than the glass. Okay, we're really packing the iron away here, guys. Back with Luke. Oh, we got more in a stack. Let's get that in my inventory just after the stack quest. Hey! More of this super awesome diamond sand. Almost wish I had diamonds. Period, though, but hey. So let's look at our little quest book. We actually finished something. I actually probably should look at these other quests. But. Well, they have a colony version. NPCs to make them work for you. Sounds cool. I'm actually surprised how few quests there are in this game. Although this goes on quite a bit. So the iron ore is complete. It is not consumed, that's good. Back. What's it? Iron ingots. Get 64 of those. Well, that's pretty simple if I can... Once I smelt them. Speaking of, I better get, I guess, more coal. I'm going to be smelting all those ingots. Okay. I hear bubbling lava. And a big slime. Yeah, I gotta say, being a golem is almost like being in creative mode. It's just so overpowered. Okay, now we got a bunch of lava. Okay, what's this? Basalt. Huh. I'm sure it's used for something. Actually, let's see, can I push you on it? No, I gotta take one first. Oh, my pick's almost gonna break. Let's use this. Oh man, I didn't mean to put it down. Okay, I gotta open this up first. So it's good for chisel and bits. And making compress. Okay, well, it's just an aesthetic thing. Which, you know, isn't too bad. It's just kind of so many resources in the world, I'm kind of hoping to find some that are. Oh, I lost one. Now I find this huge lava lake and I only have a couple buckets. Well, we can get rid of this water. Get one more bucket of lava just in case. Okay. Yeah, it's one of those times where it'd be funny to find out if ancient golems or whatever I am to need the lava. Well, Got a bunch of that sand that's not diamonds. You know, I'm gonna mess with this slime. He actually seems to be jumping to me. Oh, he is. He hurts me. Yes. I'm messing with these guys for a specific reason. They're blue. I'm kind of hoping they drop diamonds, but no. So I got ender pearls. That's good. Without having to fight endermen. I mean, I would prefer diamonds, but take what we can. So we got that one done too. Completely by accident, but. Claim my one experience point. Kill the dragon. The end dragon. To get a loot chest. So there are loot chests in this mod pack. Not very many of them, it seems. Oh wow, I hear an NPC down here. That's funny. Oh, I know what it is. I ran into it once on my other playthrough. I didn't know what I was doing and I killed him. There we go, yeah, lost miner maybe. No, he's just traveling merchant. Once I ran into one NPC called the Lost Miner, and he follows you everywhere you go, and I couldn't figure out what to do with him. I eventually killed him. I think you're supposed to lead him outside of the dungeon. I don't know if it's a quest you have to get, or is it just automatic when you do it, but I couldn't figure it out. This is a big cavern. I probably should be putting on the other side. Do my whole left is the way out thing. That's now I'm facing towards my base. Okay, I'm not. I mean, I'm deep, right? Yeah, 22. Still no diamonds. I mean, it's not Y level, was it 11 or something like that? That's supposed to be the good diamond level, but still. It's not that bad. That's not easy to find diamonds just because, well, I don't need gold. I'm running out of pick. I don't have the ability to get more. Okay, if that diamond sand is actually really awesome, it's gonna be a pain to get enough to build anything out of it. Don't mind me, Mr. Skeletons. It's gonna break. So much iron. I'm gonna break my pick to get it too. Oh man, I don't even have enough to get it all. Oh well. Let's just keep going. Watch me get diamonds down. I don't have anything to pick it up with. That's a very weird way to end a dungeon. I see some sort of like this colored block there. I'm curious what it is. No, just stone. Or it looked different. Okay, well, I guess I'll go back. I got my lava. I didn't quite get my diamond that I wanted so I could pick up my obsidian blocks. Got diamond's ugly stepsister, diamond sand. Okay, this might be a very stupid thing to do. But I'm going to try morphing into a bat. I don't know if they'll kill me. Catch me if you can. Okay, this is awesome. Yeah, the morphs in this game almost break it. It's almost like being creative. Sort of like when you get a jetpack or something in some of those other mods I've seen. Oh wow, I just had something else. Not only is the bat fly, but if you can tell, I have night vision or whatever automatically. I can see everything as bright as day. That's just so awesome. Okay, the skeletons do not attack the bat. I'm just a friendly little bat. Although, water hurts me or something. It just hit something. It hurt. Oh, I hear a witch. I don't want a witch. Oh, this is somewhere I haven't been. Hello, Mr. Zombie Spawner. Mind me. Music, really? I want any more rotten flesh. Take some of this iron. Oh, now I get another bucket. One of those things I was thinking I might get here. Mushroom goo. Melon seeds. Where the basalt is crap anyway. Okay, yeah, this is pretty cheesy. I just went out of here. I can see the sky somehow. Funny how fast the bat flies, but he walks super slow. So, here we go, follow the torches. Those treasure slimes are actually pretty cool. You get a random item based sort of on their color. So if it's a red one, last time I got an apple. Green one, I got a, or greenish blue, I got an ender pearl. Just dig my way up, but I don't have a freaking pick. Okay. I somehow missed the exit. And now it's just like one little tiny block. Yeah, I kind of messed this up when I didn't mine things properly. Okay. I am just about to dig straight up and say, forget it. Can't seem to find the way I came in. Okay, here's a bunch of torches. This is a good sign. No, I don't know. I'm going up. I take forever though, because I don't have a pick. I really don't put like the crafting table just to build a stump. Oh man, I moved. Pick a stone pickup. You never do this at home, kids. Dig straight up. I hit lava, but that's my luck. I'm not hitting any lava. Oh wow. Sandstone is taking quite a while. I think sandstone takes longer than stone. I wonder if using an axe would go faster. I know there's a bonus if you hold any item, but I can't remember if it's better with certain things. Yep, oh man, I moved. Oh, gosh. Let's see. No, and I'm just breaking my axe. But it's just a crappy stone axe. Oh well, I'll get rid of it this way, I guess. Guess I'm not gonna have a super elite diamond pick anytime soon. I wonder if this mod pack has anything cool to make resource gathering a little easier. I mean, obviously I saw that little NPC build a village thing, but usually that takes quite a while to get anywhere. I've never actually watched any, but from everything I heard, friends and stuff, it takes a while. I know from some of the skyblocks and stuff I watched, they have like sifters and stuff that make getting resources super easy. Again, they kind of break the game if you once you get to a certain level of automation, but, you know, what can you do? This is crazy. I don't remember sandstone and all that taking this long to destroy if you don't have a pick. I mean, this is as bad as if I was punching it. But these morphs are really cool. I mean, I like them. They're really versatile. They give you a lot of ability. But unlimited flight, unlimited night vision, that's okay, right? I mean, that's sort of a neater thing. But unlimited, but enemies ignore you, that's just kind of broken. I mean, it sort of ruins it. Like, what's the point of this ancient golem having 5 extra hearts or 10 extra hearts or whatever if nothing will attack you? But I'm me again, and I'm home, and I'm going to smelt slowly because I only have one furnace right now. I feel like I could probably be just build another one. Of course, I got to get my cobblestone out of my backpack. I don't know how to... I remember something about... the interface letting you move it so you can transfer items from the chest to your backpack easily, but I don't know. Let's make some magic here, guys. Get rid of the sand. Put the iron ore in there, I guess. Some of my coal in there. And then get back to what I was trying to do with get my cobblestone to make another furnace. Well, I might be able to make an oven soon. I don't know what it does or what makes it different from a furnace. But it was one of the quests I actually had next to some of the other ones that I never got to finish yet. I'm not using hoppers or anything yet. One, because I don't have a lot of iron. I mean, I just got a ton, but it's going to go quickly, trust me. But two, because, you get some experience points for taking things out of furnaces, and it's actually pretty useful for anything that has mending and stuff like that. Not that I have it yet. It's just a habit I've got into. Mending was sort of new when I stopped playing. It was really awesome. It really cut down on the grind, especially for single player, because diamond gear and stuff was so hard to get, and it broke so easily or got lost if you died without mending. And it's like there's a limited number of diamonds in the world unless you keep expanding further and further out. Okay, so where's, is that all the iron? Okay. Got that. There we go. So let's see. We got 14, 18. So we got 19 so far. But let's go upstairs and. Oh man, I gotta break 2 obsidian. Not even sure if it'd be worthwhile to have a pick, but I'm probably gonna do it anyway. So it's, I know it's gonna take forever. I don't know if it's gonna actually go any faster with an iron pick or not. Okay, where's the stairs again? Yeah, my one stairwell got destroyed. So let's fix my problem. Oops, there we go. So all I gotta do is equip my pick. Oh, I just thought of something. I got rid of my water bucket. And oh, I have one upstairs, I guess. But yeah, I just gotta go get rid of this slowly, ever so slowly. The joys of not having a diamond pick. This is what finally taught me how to read that interface properly when I first saw it. You know, it says harvest level obsidian. That's like, for the pick to work, you have to have a pick that would pick obsidian in the normal game, which is diamond. When I first saw it said harvest level iron or something on items, I thought, oh, I need to have an iron pick to get it. But no, it's just iron level, which is stone, you know. Well, there, that one, get The second one now. It's funny when obsidian used to be this super awesome block. So hard to pick and destroy. But then you got haste and all these other things that make you mine it faster, and it actually got pretty fast eventually. Not that I have any of those things. The thing is that it's like the most awesome block and properties in terms of it's indestructible almost, and you know, it makes nether portals and stuff, but it just looks so ugly. Even after the current reskin of everything, it's like they couldn't make that prettier, uglier if they tried. I got rid of all those. I mean, I gotta put them all in my backpack. Okay, so we got some cobblestone. So we gotta put one there. There we go. Yeah, so we gotta put one right there. I think it'd be easiest to work with this one. And then put one in. That way I can put it in there without burning myself. Okay, now I need to go upstairs and get my water. Well, I'll put the wall in first. Oh man, I don't have like a half slab. Oops. I don't want the gravel. Craft table. Okay, so let's make ourselves a half slab. So I can step up there. Oh man, stupid. Half slab already floors. Okay, there we go. Now we just go up here to get our water because I still didn't put the lava down, so I don't have an empty bucket. I'm an idiot. Can't think of two things in a row. Okay. Hope that's not burning my stone blocks. That's one of the problems with mod of Minecraft sometimes is I'm gonna get my carrots. Man. Now that I have zombie jerky and stuff like that, I don't know if I'm not desperately in need of carrots, but why not keep it going, you know, just in case. Although they might die now that I'm taking all this water from them, but hey. Anyway, I was saying, one of the problems with modded Minecraft at times is they modify blocks so they don't have the same properties as the blocks they're supposed to have. So that can often lead to problems. Like, say, a block being made out of what's classified as a burnable object, like wood. Even though it looks like stone. I know there was a joke for a while that some of the woods could only be broken out by a pickaxe. Even in vanilla Minecraft. Okay, so yeah, we just gotta do the same thing over here. Oh man, I gotta be careful not to burn my stairs. Although these are stairs that lead to nowhere, I think, because that's where the tower got destroyed. That doesn't go up any further. Okay, let's be careful. I'm being so bad at this. Okay, another bucket of lava, my bad. This is the super elite way to do it, by the way, guys. Just sort of build a framework of lava and then oh man, I hope that didn't just, that's an old school fashion way to make this. Yeah, I didn't have the... Whoa. Put myself on fire. That's a good way to waste your armor. And kill yourself, even. I'm worried about... Luckily... Oh yeah, it does go down. Luckily it goes that way, yeah. Not to worry about it ruining... everything on my floor. I don't think. Oh, it did get rid of all these torches, though. Oh, man. Winding, spawning my little stairwell. Okay. The door would stop it from that on. Okay, let's see if I can finish this project without destroying everything again. Let's make it a little better on myself. I'm getting some cobblestone, just what I always wanted, right? Yeah, the problem is you gotta have the water source touch the lava directly. There we go. Where's that one? No, I don't want to do that. That might destroy the water source and just get smooth stone. Maybe. Okay, let's do it this way. It'd be easier to go up. I should. If you're building this on your own, you want to start at the bottom and work your way up, because the way water works, it's easier to go down than anything else. There we go. And updates can be weird, like this time it did it down, but sometimes it'll turn to cobblestone because the lava moved over before the water did. I did decide to get a pick though. I need for all this cobblestone. Okay. Only two more to do, and hopefully they're easier because they're on the floor. Yeah, this is what it should be like. And then two right here. Huh. Can't pick up the slabs. Because I don't have any room. Get rid of the empty bucket. Oh, my floor is looking less even. But oh well. We need to go down. We need another lava source. As you can see, this takes quite a bit of lava this way. Even worse if I didn't have the obsidian I had to begin with, the 4-8 or whatever I got from Dragon Lord. Okay, and then we'll put it here. And we get another piece of cobblestone. I could have possibly put two lava down at once, but then I'd risk something going wrong. Okay guys, we got a little portal fix. Now I just need to get my flint and steel that's still in there, luckily. And we'll put our buckets away. All of them. I really need to clean up my inventory, but I'll try to do that later. Okay guys, this is we fixed our problem. And now we had to do for it. Okay, let's go check our steel real quick, and I'll probably call this our iron and call this an end of the episode. Oh yeah, this is where the stairs don't go anymore. Woo, that's a dangerous design flaw. You can just walk right out the windowsill. I want to put my water back too, but I'll do it later. So our iron's all done. And we finished another quest. Back Iron Ignis. Distalute chest, okay. Iron tools, yeah. Well, luckily I still have one in my inventory. And that's just a golden apple. Three diamonds, which leads to a diamond pick, I'm guessing. Okay, let's see what kind of loot chest you get in this game. I've seen loot chests in some others and they're kind of pathetic. So we'll see what this does. But let's get some of this junk first. Limestone, yeah, we don't want the gold now. Gold, we want the sandstone, gunpowder, green. Granite, grave dust. Really be useful to get the big chest I have down there working. Because it, you know, would be a one big pool for everything, so I wouldn't have to double up items. Let's see what this loot chest is, guys. Oh wow, dungeon loot. Which is junk. I mean, yeah, it's junk. I mean, some of it's, you know, sort of semi-useful, but yeah, it's pretty junk. I mean, the Man of Steel is probably the only thing in here that's really worth anything. Oh, I got bones. I mean, seriously, a loot chest that gave you bones. I mean, it's just disappointing in every way possible. Got music, but no CD player, so what can you do? But, yeah, guys, I'm gonna probably call it later and gonna show my, little brokenness. In fact, bear with me a little bit longer. I'm gonna show how cheesy this is in a screenshot by, oh, it's in the daytime. Just gonna stand a bunch of skeletons. Hey, did that guy just steal from me? I heard a little pluck sound. Oh well, yeah, I was gonna show, but whatever. Of course there's no monsters around when you want them. But, yeah, guys, catch you later. Bye.